Again, the British government sends out a mission. Talks begin with the Indian leader. Mr. Jinnah is firm and reiterates the demand for Pakistan. Congress is equally firm that India should not be divided. The Nawab of Bhopal leads the princely order. He tries to reconcile the two, but no agreement is possible. The mission makes its own proposals. British India and the Indian states are to form one union consisting of three zones, two of which would have a predominantly Muslim majority. The interim government is to be formed of an equal number of these in Congress representatives. The League decides that the basis of Pakistan is inherent in the plan and accepts it. The leaders of Congress, on the other hand, are against the equal representation for League and Congress. They reject the plan. The British decide, regardless of Congress opposition, to form an interim government with League ministers. The League agrees to join. It is a triumph for Mr. Jinnah. This is too much for Congress, which claims more seats. It refuses to join the interim cabinet. With Congress intransigent, the British government goes back on its stand. Mr. Jinnah accuses the British of a breach of faith and withdraws the support of the plan. It is now time for direct action by the Muslims. Ties with the British Indian past are severed. All titles bestowed by the British are returned. And then there is another vote passed by Congress. Suddenly it joins the interim cabinet. Mr. Nehru is at its head. Everywhere the Muslims protest and Black Day is observed. Simultaneously, the Viceroy continues negotiations with Mr. Jinnah for the League to join the government. Mr. Jinnah gives his approval. Mr. Liaquat Ali Khan heads five nominees of the Muslim League who are sworn in as members of the Central Cabinet. At the same time, the League reaffirms that it will not take part in the Constituent Assembly whose power Congress misinterprets. Soon, serious differences appear within the cabinet and a complete breakdown is imminent.